edge of a breakthrough, but couldn't see. The devil really had me, but Jesus came and grabbed me, and cleaned me everywhere, so I wouldn't let go.
God's mercy kept me.
Life is too short to have your life in bondage, to keep yourself on the spot, to make yourself miserable. Life is too short to live a life without meaning, without a purpose, without a deliberate intention. Life is too short to live a careless and a miserable life. Take your life back. It's important for everyone listening to me today to take their lives back. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is Take Your Life Back. I'm so excited to be in your various lives and homes. Personally, I'm grateful. One thing is sure, life is a choice. You make your choice makes you. We are all products of our various choices. When you make a decision or you make choices that helps you to go to where you are destined to go to move towards a positive direction of your vision and your intentions, it's a lot of joy. When people are not fulfilled, when they are not happy about where they are, when they feel stuck, they feel frustrated. And that is the reason for your addiction. That's why you medicate your pain with drugs, with alcohol, masturbating, watching pornography, drinking to stupor, going clubbing, dancing, doing things that you know to yourself and to your sense of judgment that it might not be good. I don't want to say it's not good, but you know that you are not really, really comfortable about it, but you just overlook the shame and overlook the embarrassment and you just tell yourself it doesn't matter. I'm sure you are hearing me today and you are saying it doesn't matter. You have said a lot of it doesn't matter. The reason why you are passionate about saying that is because you know that it matters. So your conscience, your heart is pricking you. No, it matters. To live a life of promiscuity matters. To become a person that sleeps around with people, messing up your mental, emotional, psychological life matters. But you tell yourself it doesn't matter because you don't want to take responsibility. You don't want to accept. You don't want to take charge of your life. You don't want to care if anything happens to your life. If you are like that, I welcome you to the world of recovery. I welcome you to the world of taking back your life. I said to myself one day, I was in this situation. My life was going down the drain. I was losing it because of what I went through growing up. I'm going to be addressing some foundational truth here that makes us to live a life that we don't like, that makes us to feel frustrated in life, that makes us not to take our lives back, thinking that we cannot take it back. But I have a good news for you. You can take your life back. You have actually been given everything that pertains to life and godliness. You have what it takes. Now, let me take the part of life God has given us by the power that is in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Everything according to divine power. 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3 says, according to his divine power, he has given unto us all things that pertaineth unto life. Let's take life. If God has given you, by according to his divine power, all that pertain to life, then the enemy does not have a right to take your life and toy with it, to take your life and play games with it, to use your life as a point of embarrassment even to yourself. That is not the counsel of God. Why? Because he has given you all things that pertain unto life. Now, if you have this at the back of your mind, that there is a life that I have by divinity, by the maker and the creator, but this life I'm living is not speaking the reality of that divinity, the power that the creator has given to you. If you notice that this is just a contrast to what you are supposed to deliver, then you need to go inside, fight this battle, deal with yourself, and take your life back. You cannot allow yourself to go out of course. You know, when people are not on course, it looks as if they are under a curse. You know, when you are not on your route, on the journey that you are supposed to take, it just looks as if you are under a curse. But one thing is sure and one thing is real. Whatever the case may be, God has a power. He has his own power, but you have your power. If you have been listening to one of the episodes about life, what God will do, you cannot do. What you will do, God cannot do. There's a part that you will do, and there's a part that God will do. If you don't do your part, God is helpless. God is handicapped. God cannot do what you will do. God will not do what you can do. And that takes me to where I'm going. One thing that was sure about this man called the prodigal son was to come to himself. He came to himself, and that took him on a journey to take his life back. Take your life back from that riotous living. Take your life back from the feeling that you have, that you have to compromise your conscience to do things that are absurd, that are abnormal. Take your life back from the dungeon of shame, several abortions, multiple partners in relationship that are sexual. Take your life back from the clutches of pornography, of masturbation. Take your life back. It is your duty to do it. And the decision starts from, I will go back. I'll go back to my source. I'm taking it all the way. Whatever the price I have to pay, and the price I have to pay, paint and pay, I'll go all the way. I will not deceive myself. You know why? The moment you find yourself in this situation and you refuse to do anything about it, nothing gets better. It's going to get worse. It's going to keep you stuck, going to keep you on the spot. You are not going to make progress. And honestly speaking, the plan that your Creator has for you, like I read, according to his divine power, he has given unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him that has called us unto glory and virtue. You are called unto glory. You are called unto virtue. You are called unto a good life, beautiful life, amazing life, awesome life. That's what you are called unto. But when you find these forces controlling you, destroying your God-given ability and potentials, then you have to come back to yourself and tell yourself, I can't continue like this. I'll be right back. Thank you for listening.
Can I get a witness in here?
So I wouldn't let go.
I almost gave up.
I almost gave up. I was right at the edge of the breakthrough, but couldn't see it.
Welcome back to Take Your Life Back with Olufunke Adetuberu. Any forces, any power, any urge, whatever it is that is forcing itself against your will, against your conscience, against your desire, against your dreams, against your potentials, you need to take your life back. Take it back big time. Get a life. Make a decision. Make a choice. The prodigal son said to himself, I'm going back home. I've had it to the peak. I am not going to continue like this. Whatever it is, I have a life in God. He has given me all that pertain to life, all things. and I'm going to maximize that life. Whatever it is that is killing your joy, one of the powerful strength that a man has is to have this overwhelming joy. Not in wealth, not because I have dollars or pounds sterling or euros in my account, but the joy that money cannot buy. It's an overwhelming joy. That is a strength of everyone that has his life in his hands. But when you have lost your joy, you are bound with shame. You are bound with so much regret. It's like you want to get out of this world. You've concluded that nothing will get better. You're losing it. Can I say this to you? One of the things that destroys a man, that messes up the life of a man, is shame, and is highly destructive. Shame is redeemable. The only thing that is not redeemable is death. Shame can turn to fame. I've seen people that have been shamed before. Shamed because they did something that was wrong, and everybody was on their case, and they were talking and yelling and saying things about them. And because they traced back their steps, they went back to the roots of their crisis. They understood the dynamics of their struggle, and they were not lying to themselves. Before they knew it, they came out like the prodigal son. I love the testimony of that young man called the prodigal son. You know, when he said he was coming back, there was celebration. When he was going, there was nobody that knew. It was himself, his dad, probably his senior brother, that knew that he actually went to his father boldly and said, "Daddy, give me everything that belongs to me. I'm getting out of here. I want to go and squander the money." When he was going, it was not a celebration. It was a shameful outing. An outing that brought regret and shame and pain to his dad. But when he made up his mind to come back, the whole city celebrated. They killed cows. When you come back to yourself, there is celebration. When you make a decision to take your life back, there is joy. When you make a decision to come back, to deal with the deep-seated shame and the experiences you've had, having to be on the street, having to live as an alcoholic, having to live as someone who has aborted, we're always on taking strong drinks, who is always going about with women and with men and things, you know, shameful acts. The moment he came back to himself, a celebration party was thrown. The whole city knew that this guy is being restored. Listen to me. When you take back your life, your mess becomes your message. You become a voice in the place of your recovery. When you take your life back, you become a specimen of God's mercies. If you can take your life back, you become a voice of relevance in that situation. I've seen people that there are no voices anymore because they are there. They have refused to have insight. They never bother to think or know that something is wrong with them. And because of that, they keep going down. They keep going down. They keep drenching in the pool of their crisis, in the pool of their lifestyle that has brought shame to them. So they are drenched in the pool of shame. They are soaked in shame. And that's why they have not made any significant steps to progress. Their children are angry with them. Their spouses have left them. I've had cases where their wife had to leave, their husbands had to leave. They have become a point of shame and embarrassment to the society and to their family. And their children are even so upset that they cannot get in touch and get involved with their lives. But listen to me. When you make a choice to take your life back, you become a positive reference point. You become a testimonial of God's goodness, a testimonial of all that God can do. But listen to me. One of the things that motivates you to change is to know that you have all that pertains to life. You've been given all things that pertain to life. Everything is available. The only thing is, you have to make a decision. Choose it this day. The only thing God cannot tamper with in the life of his creation is to tamper with their will, to tamper with their conscience, to tamper with their determination. He will not do that. The moment God begins to tamper with your convictions, with your determinations, with your mind that is set and made up, God becomes a manipulator. And God does not manipulate any man. He allows you to choose. He said, choose in this day whom you will serve. Now, if I say go back to the root and understand that you have to do it yourself, like I said, what God will do, you cannot do. What you will do, God cannot do. The moment that comes to it, thank you for listening to me. I'll be right back.
Somebody next to him. I was really down. I was really down. The devil really had me. But God's mercy kept me. I'm here tonight because of God's mercy.
Welcome back. This is Take Your Life Back with Olufunke Adetuberu. I really want to appreciate the fact that when shame comes, shame can actually be a tool for a lifting. Shame can be a self-help to get rid of some of the things that has taking over our lives. When you are feeling ashamed about the fact that you come home drunk, you have to call home sick, you are always the subject of conversation and family meetings in your family, you have become the black sheep of the family, and you are feeling ashamed. Wow, that's another key. It was shame that took the prodigal son back home. He just told himself, what a shame. How can I be eating with pigs? I'm going back. I'm tired. Enough is enough. And that was a turning point. So sometimes God allows shame to come to us so that we can think, so that we can make a difference. Shame can help you to go back to a place of healing, restoration, renewing of purpose and vision, and you begin to have meanings for your life. Shame can help you to take charge of your life back. Shame can cause you to look at your current situation and to tell yourself, I have to go forward. I have to move forward with confidence. I cannot take it anymore. Shame can also help you to look at everyone around you, your siblings, your family members, and you tell them, you will change what you are saying about me. I'm going to make sure that you will speak positively over my life. You have said a lot of things. You've concluded that I'm the black sheep. You've seen me in a wrong light. But I promise you, very shortly, you will see me and I'll become a positive reference point. Sometimes that is what shame does. You are listening to me today, you're living in shame, you have had it all, you try to change, you've tried to pray, you have tried to fast, and you are still struggling. Please don't hesitate. Send me a text. This is Olufunke Adetuberu. By the grace of God, the power, the ability, the grace is available. Don't forget, He has given us all things that pertain to life and godliness. You have all things. Send me a text on +234 9035 814892 or +234 9020101080. Or you can send me a mail on cryonmenow@gmail.com. cryonmenow@gmail.com. Or you can follow me on my Twitter angle, Adetuberu Abimbola. You have no choice to run to a place of recovery. Recovery is possible. To take your life back is possible. But you can't do it in isolation. You do it in the company of people that can help you. You know, when you listen to other people's stories and you see how God has helped some people to get out of their situations and circumstances, the things that makes them feel miserable, the shameful things in their life, and you see them with their testimonies of goodness or favor, the things that has happened to them, you will say, wow, if this person can be free, I can be free. If this person can take his life back, I can take my life back. If that person can take her life back, I can take my life back. And that's the beauty of recovery. You network. You come together as a team. And the moment you do that, you become a voice of freedom to other people that are struggling. Listen to me. Take your life back. Don't allow yourself to stay on the spot and keep going down the slope and getting into the well of your struggles. When you come out as a star. When you come out as a wounded healer. You become a helper of other people's destiny, and your life will be so beautiful. I will be going into another session of understanding some things that makes a life to be taken. What actually took your life? Because I know you're asking me, well, I don't understand. Where is this thing coming from? Whom did I offend? What happened? What is the root cause of this? I'll begin to share with you. Most of the time, everything that happens to us in life, they are our family system. Everybody stems from a home. The home front, where you stem from, determine how farther and further you will go in life. A lot of people have, their life was taken from them by their parents. Some, their lives were taken from them by their guardians. Some, their lives were taken from them, from their tutors. People that are supposed to push them to greatness, lead them well, guide them rightly. There were people that dropped them. There were people that took their lives from them. For instance, like a lady that told me, he said, Ma, it was my teacher when I was in primary school that comes to teach me at home. He started molesting me, started sleeping with me, started, you know, messing up with myself, messing up with my mind. She said, that was the beginning of my life being taken away from me. And from that junction till today, I have two children for two different men. I sleep around. I have STD. Several things had followed since that episode because she was wrongly exposed to sexual activities. And that tells you something. That was not her fault. So when I say take your life back, you have to be determined. You have to make up your mind what God will do, you will not do. What you will do, God will not do. I'm not saying that you are the cause. I'm not saying you are the reason. Life can hit you hard. When life hits you, your life can be taken. When life hits you, you can find yourself in the pit. But it's possible to still take your life back. Today, this lady, she's one of my wonderful women that goes about with me preaching and talking about her testimony. She has become a wounded healer. She has become a restorer of other people's broken worlds. She has become a voice and a mentor to many who have found themselves in such a terrible situation. She took her life back and she became a voice. I want to say a very big thank you to all my listeners. My name is Olufunke Adetuberu. This is Take Your Life Back. You have any questions, you are worried about anything, send me an email. cryonmenow@gmail.com, or send me a message also on my Instagram, Olufunke Adetuberu, or send me a text message on 090-20-1080 +234-90-20-10-1080 or 234-90-358-14892. Either way, I will definitely get back to you. I want to say a very big thank you to all of you. Keep telling people. Can you just tell people and tell them something good is happening on this radio station? I'm taking my life back. I'm not going to stay on the spot. I'm making progress. I'll see you some other time. Thank you for listening.
I almost let go. Depression weighed me down. God help me go, so I wouldn't let go. God's mercy kept me, so I wouldn't let go.